Welcome to Team B Film.
Today, we are going to teach you our top 5 math games.
Yes, this video is part of a collaboration hosted by Kids Learning for Life. And we were so excited to join in because we love games. And if they're educational to boot, that makes it all the better. Bug, you want to introduce our channel?
We are Team B Farm. We're a homeschool family of 5. I, Bug. And, pardon background noise. Those are my sisters playing.
All right, so this is Bug, our oldest. She is 9. This is Boo, our second youngest now. Sit down, Boo. She is 3, and baby Buddy wanted to join in the video today.
Of course he wouldn't miss it.
He is 1 week old. Mm-hmm. All right, should we get started on our games?
Yay! Mm-hmm.
Swamp. It teaches basic addition and subtraction skills for kids who are 4, 5, or 6.
Yeah, so it says 5+, but as long as your kids are learning beginning addition skills, they can go ahead and play this one. So there is a board game, and there are 2 number die and 1 die that has a plus or minus. You roll that to know whether to add or subtract, and you move around the board. It's a pretty simple, straightforward game, but it gets the
main point across, and it's pretty fun too.
Yeah, it gets the math component in a simple way. Okay, so again, that one is Some Swamp. All right, our next game is
Sleeping Queens.
Sleeping Queens.
It is a game that does addition a step higher than Some Swamp. And it's good for kids who have outgrown Some Swamp and are ready for the next level. Also, this game is so well loved. No box.
So, Sleeping Queens covers addition packs 1 through 10. You can make it more difficult by adding in multiplication, division, that kind of thing. This is not meant to be a math game, but it does cover basic math facts. And you're trying to make math facts like 1 + 3 = 4, and you would lay that down. Yeah, that would be an easy one. You would lay that down for one of your plays in the game. So Sleeping Queens is a favorite at our house.
Great.
All right, our next game is
Clix. It's an old favorite of ours. It's a dice game, and it teaches math problems a few steps above Sleeping Queens. It's like 44 plus 45.
Yeah, so throughout the game, you're doing simple addition skills.
And at the end, it adds 2-digit plus 2-digit plus 2-digit plus 2-digit minus maybe minus something.
Yeah, so this one has been great for our second grader who has been learning that 2-digit addition to practice her skills that she's already learned. This is a family favorite. Again, it is not meant to be a math game, but it does do
math.
But
it did that by accident.
And we love it. All right, Bug, our next one is
Pizza Fraction Fun. It combines delicious pizza with fraction learning.
All right, so it does say, I think, where is it? Ages 6+, but this could go all the way through middle school because you're working on adding subtractions. In fact, I just told Bug that we are going to start playing this game, get it out again, because she has been practicing improper fractions in her math.
And, oh, by the way, I made up a little phrase to tell you what fractions are improper. Improper fractions are improper because they say, I'm equal to or bigger than the number below me.
All right, so the way that this works is you are trying to build a pizza and you can mix fractions. Like this pizza takes 1/2 plus 1/4 and then 2/8 to make a whole pizza. There is a game. Our family just likes to play around with the pieces and practice their math that way. You can do either one. In fact, there is quite a few different games that you can play. I don't think we've even played them all, have we, Bug?
No.
No, there's quite a few different games that you can play within this one little game. All right, and our last game that we have to share is
Pet Me.
Pet Me, and Pet Me practices
division. Early division. Kids 7, 8, 9 could work with this.
Yeah, this is a great introduction to division skills. The way, oops, we're losing pieces. Oops, do you want to explain how to play, Bug?
So you go around the board collecting pets and play with those pets.
Yeah, you win!
So you go around the board and you are trying to divide your food among the animals. So if I wanted to adopt these parrots, I had 25 chilies, I would need to divide them equally among my 5 parrots. And there are little, since we're losing pieces here, there are little pieces, manipulatives, that you can practice dividing with. So it's a great introduction to division for your kiddos.
Also, if you were green, then you put the green pet tag on the parrot space, showing these parrots are all mine.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so you're trying to adopt it. Animals are always fun for kids. We totally recommend this game. We hope that you found some fun games to play, and don't forget to check out the playlist down below. We'll catch you next time.
Bye.
Thanks for watching.
Bye.